everybody, and it's Elisa from Elisa's American Girl Dolls. And today we're going to be doing a fun little craft. We are going to be finding out two creative ways to display pictures for your American Girl dolls. This is basically like two very easy DIYs on how to display some pictures for your dolls. Sorry I haven't been uploading in like forever. It's just that school and basic life is just like really, really crazy right now, and I haven't gotten the chance. But here I am right now with a new video. So let's just get right into it. Ain't yours, I'd rather have none. I don't need a fortune teller. The first way is to make your own DIY picture frame, and this is super duper simple. You only need a few things for this DIY. The first thing are some pictures. You can choose whatever kind of pictures you want, but I recommend like printing out some kind of pictures. And a little life hack, if you don't want to use actual pictures you took of your doll, you can just search up their number. Like for example, Abigail is number 22. I just searched her up and I found a picture of her. Or like Samantha, I just searched up American Girl Samantha and that came up. And for Whiskers the cat, I searched up Himalayan Kitten and I found these two pictures. I searched up Caroline's number and I found her. I got a picture of the New York skyline. A picture of LA. I have a little word art of Samantha. Word art of Abigail. Word art of Caroline. And a little like fashion sketches picture. So you can just get creative and basically use any kind of pictures that you want to use. And you will also need binder clips. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, these are binder clips. Depending on the size of the picture, you can use any size. I have this like really, really big one. I have a medium sized one. And I have like a really small one. So just these binder clips, and I'm using multicolored ones because I feel like that looks really nice. You will need scissors. And you can use regular tape, but if you want like a fun finish, I am going to use these like decorative fashion tape, but you can really use regular tape and that'll work. And you will need some sort of cardboard. It's hard to see, I know, but I'm using an American Girl doll box. I changed the camera angle so you could see it a little better. And I'm using the Dreamy Daisy flatbed box. And this works perfectly because it's not a super, super hard cardboard. But then like, this is a nice flimsy soft cardboard, and that works really, really well as the back of the picture. The thing that you'll need is not a requirement again, but I feel like it will really make your picture frame a lot more interesting. I use these decorations. You can use any kind of like little craft supplies to make it really nice and creative. You can use stickers or like stars and felt stuff. And I'm using the leftover materials that I got on my DIY, what's it called? Ugly sweater sock set. That was really fun, but I have these extra materials, so I'm gonna use them here, and they work perfectly. And the last thing that you need is that if you're going to use materials like that, you're obviously gonna need some glue. Getting started, the first thing that you're gonna need to do is obviously to cut out your picture. I finished cutting out my picture and I chose to use the Himalayan Kitten one. Even though they don't have this out there, I felt like it was really, really cute to display. And the next step that we're going to be doing is taking our cardboard piece. And then we put our picture on it. And I'm so sorry, I forgot to tell you about two more materials that you're going to need. You're going to need a pen or something to write with. And you're going to need a ruler. I'm super sorry that I forgot to tell this to you. But what we're going to do first is we are going to measure, I'd say about a half an inch above the picture. And then we're going to mark it. So it's half an inch above the picture, something like that. You can sort of see that. Yeah, and that's kind of like your guideline. And then what we're gonna wanna do is take our ruler. We're gonna line it up with that little guide mark there. And then make a line. Wait, that did not show up. My marker or my pen really. I went and got a lot better marker. So what we want to do is take our ruler, line it up on that little guide mark we made, and then make a line. Okay, this marker sucks too, but it kind of shows up. You can probably see that, but it kind of did show up. Basically, what we want to do next is do the same exact thing on all the sides. Sorry if it's a little bit hard to see, but as you can see, I made my guidelines all around, and that is where you're going to cut it out. Telescope to see that you're the one. I cut out the piece of cardboard that we're going to be using. As you can see, it fits our picture quite nicely. And that's what we're going to be wanting to do, is attaching our picture onto there now. And you can use your regular tape, and I'm going to pick a fun pattern from all of my fashion tapes. Since the picture itself is like flower themed, I'm going to use this nice pink fashion tape that has flowers on it. I feel like that would really nicely fit the theme. So before we tape, we want to measure it. And we're going to make sure that the picture is still a half an inch from the border at all of the sides. So that's half an inch. Yeah, wait, no, that's not half an inch. That's half an inch. Or instead of just using your ruler, let's just eyeball it and see as we can get it in the center as best as we possibly can. And I think that looks pretty good. Now that we have it aligned, we're just going to tape the whole outside in this beautiful flower tape. And I'm just going to do a time lapse of that. Baby, the password, nothing but practice. As you can see, I finished the taping process, but I have like all these ends and stuff, so we're gonna do some little like touch-ups and stuff, and I'll get back to you. I finished sort of fixing up the taping job. I feel like I could have done a lot better, but I didn't really spend enough time on it. But that's okay, because now it's time to decorate, and this is where you can really make it your own and unleash your creativity. So I'm going to go and do that. I went downstairs and finished decorating, and I gotta say, it looks pretty cool. I put some mix-match pom-poms on the side, and I used gold and white mix-match pom-poms, and it has some little silver sparkle thingies, I guess you could call them. And I also used two little sparkly stars. One is silver and one is gold, kind of going with those two, and that pretty much completes the decoration aspect. Now we've got only one more step, and then you're done with your DIY photo frame and stand. So as you can see, I finished the decorations, and you're gonna need your binder clip. I suggest for a picture this size, which is, if I measure it, about 3.5 by 3.5 inches and stuff like that, which is actually a quite normal size picture. You're gonna need to use a jumbo size binder clip. And what you do is you take your picture and your binder clip, but you don't clip it all the way. You only clip it in like partially. That did not work. It's hard to do though, because it's hard to open. It's like partially. And then you flip the two metal things up, and then it holds up the photo for you. So that's how it looks like. And that does it for our first DIY, and now it's on to the second one. Back at it again with a jump shot. I'm aiming for you and I won't stop. For the second DIY, you're going to need a piece of string. So if I measure this, it depends on where you're planning to hang it. But if I measure this one, we're talking about 2 1/4 feet. So just a piece of string, and I'm using this beautiful pink one. You're also going to need the tape again. Well, this time the tape is more for just decorative uses, so I feel like it would be great to use the decorative tape. You're going to need a lot more binder clips. So I think I'm going to display like 4 pictures or something. So I'm using 4 small binder clips. I think the small binder clips will work for this one. And you can also use any binder clip size though. And this time you're going to need more than just 1 picture. So you can, like I showed you, I have a whole bunch of pictures. Just choose your favorite pictures. And you're also going to need this cardboard stuff again. Now you might need to use like a little bit of a bigger box though, because we have to do more than just 1 picture. And I think that does it for, oh wait, no, I'm not going to forget to tell you this time. You're also going to need your marker and your ruler and anything that you want to decorate with. To get started, just cut out as many pictures as you think that you're going to hang. Baby, the past was nothing but practice, now I'm set.
When you give me access, I just see
my heart. I finished cutting up all the photos, and since this is going to go on Caroline's bedroom, I did everything that Caroline loves. So I have a picture of Caroline herself. I have a little word art that says Caroline. I have some fashion sketches. And a picture of that, I forget what it's called, for that beach in Los Angeles. Well, I'm being really specific today, but yeah, I printed out just 4 pictures. Basically, what you want to do is do the exact same thing in what we did with the last DIY for the cardboard. You're going to take your cardboard, and then you're going to like line up your picture, and then measure half an inch and cut out and all that stuff. So I'm just going to do it for all 4 pictures. And I'm going to need a new box because this is not going to be big enough. So just warning you, you might need to get some more cardboard. I'm going to go on to do my next photos. I wanted to remind you what you do after you cut it out is you kind of line it up and just see, I kind of like eyeball it and see where it is to make sure it's like half an inch from the edge. And then you pick one of your fashion tapes and then, you know, like tape it on. This is what it's supposed to look like after you finish taping. So I'm going to go and do the rest. For the rest of the photos, for the cardboard, I'm just using a Truly Me doll box. I finished up putting the decorative tape like over it, I guess you could say, and attaching the cardboard to the back. And these are how they look. I put a black and white stripes one on Caroline. I put the like a cute little beachy boho design on the LA one. I put a nice fashion lace design on the fashion sketches one. And last but certainly not least, I put a gem design on Caroline's picture. And now, if you remember what we did last time, you are going to go decorate it and personalize it. I finished up on decorating, and for Caroline's photo, since I have a gem outline, I also put some, like a gem heart, just a white plain gem, and a star. For the one with Caroline's name, I put 3 black mini pom-poms to match the trim. For the LA one, I decided to do a bit of contrast. So I put 4 green sequins and 1 gold star. And for the fashion designs one, I put a silver star and a red heart, which is pretty much the same thing as Caroline's picture, except without the extra sparkles. And making it is super duper simple. What we want to do is lay out our string, and you probably won't be able to see it all at once because it's really, really long. But we want to just lay out our string and then take our binder clip. I have 4 of them that I'm going to use. One is actually a different color. So 3 are white and 1 is red. So I'm going to put the red one first. It's this little red one. And I'm going to use it to hang Caroline's picture. And how I do that is that I take the picture and I kind of sort of clip it on to the string. So you clip it the string and then you clip the actual photo. And as you can see, it is securely attached then. It move a little bit, but that's fine. And you can even secure it more with some fashion tape or something. But that's basically how you do it. And you can, I'm gonna do the rest of them. I finished clipping each one of them onto the string. So I'm going to go hang it on Caroline's bed and show it to you guys. I'm actually going to do my outro right now because I just felt like that'd be better. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this fun little video. And if you did, please remember to like, comment, and click that little red subscribe button for more amazing videos like this one. Bye! 'Cause you're the hottest on the block. Nothing dim in your light. But all the options that you got. Wouldn't ever treat you right.